algebra is one of the greatest things that we have in this world. But what is algebra, some of you may ask? Well, algebra is a branch of math. It is usually the math that you learn in middle school or your early years of high school. Why is it so important, though? Well, learning algebra makes you think more logically and smarter in your everyday life. A lot of the things that we have in this world wouldn't be possible or even exist if we didn't have algebra. So, who should we thank for coming up with this great concept? Well, the person that we should thank is our great Muslim brother, Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khwarizmi. Al-Khwarizmi was born in 780 in East Persia, around where today is known as Uzbekistan. He lived during the Abbasid Caliphate. Al-Khwarizmi was very smart from his childhood, mashallah. His interest, though, was especially in math. Historians say that Al-Khwarizmi moved to Baghdad when he was very young to gain more knowledge, since during that time, Baghdad was very good in education. The world's best knowledge from Greece, Persia, India, China, and from all over the world was collected in Baghdad. So, when Al-Khwarizmi moved to Baghdad, he started to learn new things every day. He especially loved learning math from India and Greece, who were the most advanced at that time. When Al-Khwarizmi got older, he wanted to take math to the next level. He wanted to come up with more complex concepts so that the world could become better. But unfortunately, this was not really possible because most people at that time would use the Roman numerals. This made advanced math close to impossible. Al-Khwarizmi decided to not use the Roman numerals. Instead, Al-Khwarizmi adopted the number system that goes from 0 to 9, and that's the system that we use now. And using that system, Al-Khwarizmi created the concept of algebra. Algebra really took math to the next level, but a lot of people were against Al-Khwarizmi's idea because they were scared of trying something new and changing the concepts of the past. They didn't want to change the whole system of doing math because it could harm them if Al-Khwarizmi's concepts were wrong. Al-Khwarizmi knew this, but he knew that sometimes you have to take a leap of faith to make the world a better place. So, after Al-Khwarizmi did a lot of experiments with his concepts of algebra, around 830, Al-Khwarizmi wrote the book Kitab al-Mukhtasir fi Hisab al-Jabr wal-Muqabala, which means the brief book on calculation by completion and balancing. This was the first algebra book, and it explained and introduced many things. That's why Al-Khwarizmi is called the father of algebra. In his book, he gave his math concept the name Al-Jabr, which means completion in Arabic. Later, in the 12th century, this book was translated into Latin, and the translator changed the word Al-Jabr into algebra. The translator also changed Al-Khwarizmi's name into Al-Khwarizmi, and this spread all over Europe. And that's how we got the word algorithm and algebra, and got the great concept of algebra to spread all over the world. So, to sum up, Al-Khwarizmi created the concept of algebra and changed our world forever. Without algebra, we wouldn't have computers, phones, advanced machines, modern engineering, and a lot more other things. Let's all thank Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khwarizmi for the great difference he made in this world by asking Allah to give him the highest place in Jannah. Ameen. And next time, when you see or hear about algebra, remember that it's because of our great Muslim brother, Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khwarizmi. Oh, and if you have any other Muslim heroes or inventors from the past or from our present time, please let us know in the comments down below. Don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe to our channel, and share this video with all of your friends and family. And until next time, Assalamu alaikum.